Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today in this video tutorial we are going to learn how to use jQuery Toastr in ASP.NET MVC application. So let's get started. First of all, I will go into the Visual Studio and I'm using Visual Studio 2015 for this purpose. So now I will create a new project. So I will click on new project setting. So here I will select ASP.NET web application and I will give name to it Toastr example. Now I will click on OK. So it will create a new project for us. So here I will select MVC template and now I will click on OK again. And our new project is being created. Let's wait till the project is created. As you can see here in notification bar, the create project. Now it is restoring packages for ASP.NET MVC project. It will take time according to the internet connection, so it may be processed earlier or maybe take some time. So I will close this. Our new project has been created. Now what I will do, first of all I will go into the solution explorer and here is the project solution and it is the project, and now I will click on the project, right click on the project, and here you can see manage NuGet packages. So I will go into the manage NuGet packages and here I will browse and will install NuGet packages for Toastr. So here it is the first result, Toastr by John Papa. So this is a very popular plugin and NuGet package used in ASP.NET MVC projects. It provides lots of good notifications, Toastr like. So I will install it into the project. So now as you can see in the package manager console, it is creating or downloading the package for Toastr in our project. So let's wait till it is completed. I hope this all steps are familiar for the .NET MVC developers, and I hope you also know how to install different packages, NuGet packages for solution you have used in daily life development in every project. So it is not the new thing for any developer. So it is asking for the installation confirmation. I will click on OK. So now it is installing and as you can see the detail, and it is successfully installed as you can see here in our project. So now I will close the Toastr NuGet packages and I will close this one also. Now I will go into the solution explorer and in the content you can see we have our toastr.css file, and in the script we have our toastr.js file. So our package has been installed. So what I will do, I will go into the shared folder and I will open the layout. So as you can see, the layout file contains the main project template for our whole project, and you can see the head and body section here. So what I will do, I will reference the CSS and JavaScript here. Okay, so I will open the content and here is the toastr.css file. I will drag and drop it here. So it is referenced, and now I will scroll down a bit, and in this place I will drag the script file of the Toastr. So here is our Toastr file, and I will drag and drop it here. So our project has been referenced the Toastr file successfully. So what I will do next, I will first of all run this project, and we want to see that our project is currently working or not, because we haven't run our project till we have created. So I will press Ctrl F5, and our project has been start building. And let's see if we have any error or not in our project, and I hope it will run successfully. So our project has been created successfully. Our project has been run successfully. So I will go back into the Visual Studio, and now I will open the home view where we will work for our Toastr. So I will open home and index. As you can see in the Chrome, we have home controller and index view. So here we will put different buttons, and we'll check how to use Toastr on different button clicks. So I will go back to the Visual Studio, and let's remove this unnecessary code from here. Okay, and this one also. And here what I will do, I will create some button HTML, and will provide some script class. So btn default, okay, and value will be Toastr success, and I will also provide ID to it, so it will have Toastr success. And now I will create this more buttons just like that. So I will copy and paste it. I will paste it 4 times because we have 4 types of Toastr. So I will give different IDs, Toastr info, and this one will be Toastr danger, and this one will be Toastr I will have Toastr warning as well, and also change the text Toastr info and Toastr danger and Toastr warning. So let's have a look on our project and what we have got. So now I will press Ctrl F5, as you can see we have 4 different buttons: Toastr success, info, and Toastr danger. And I will handle on the click events of this button, and will display different types of Toastr according to the button click. So I will make it 12 columns, and let's add a line break here as well. Okay, now save it. So here I will provide a section of scripts to write JavaScript, and here I will add a script tag, and will provide type text JavaScript, and in this, so let's type dollar function to initialize DOM elements, and here we will have dollar function, and I will close this by ending semicolon, and here we will handle our button click. So what I will do, I will provide a button click handler. So here we have to provide ID of the button. So we have Toastr success dot click, and we have to handle this click event by providing function in it. So here you can see that click handling of this button has been created. So let's verify this, and let's for now just display a alert to click on button and verify that our project our jQuery is properly configured or not, and button click has been working or not. So let's click on Toastr success. As you can see the alert here, so our jQuery is up and running. So now what I will do, I will copy and paste this also 4 times, and here we will have Toastr info, and next we will have Toastr danger, and finally we will have Toastr warning as well. So now let's click all the buttons one by one and go into the prompt, and let's refresh it by pressing Ctrl F5. So I will click on Toastr success, we will have OK alert and Toastr info working as well, Toastr danger is working as well, and now Toastr warning as well. So now we will provide some code of the Toastr to display different kind of Toastr according to the button, and it is very useful. You can use in any of your project and while working to provide a good user experience to the user. So it is very lightweight and very easy to use, and provide good classes and designs, and also some advanced settings as well. You can search the Toastr on Google and further find something advanced according to it. So you can use it according to your need in the project. So I will go back to the Visual Studio. So to display Toastr, we need to type Toastr, and it will have different options like Toastr success, as you can see here. And now I will open bracket, so it will provide some intelligence. So first of all, we need to type message, and our message will be success Toastr, and our heading will be Toastr, and we can also provide some options, so we will look at after this simple example. So now we have our Toastr success, and let's go back to the Chrome and let's see it is working or not. So I will refresh it by pressing F5, and when we click on Toastr success, you can see the Toastr has been generated, and it is very lightweight and good design for our project, and we can use in different contexts of our project, and we also provide some settings. So I will go back to the Visual Studio and I will provide same Toastr here. So toastr.info, and heading will be Toastr, sorry, info Toastr. Okay, and heading will be Toastr. Now I will provide danger Toastr. So here I will type toastr.danger, and message will be danger Toastr, same as we type above, and message heading will be Toastr. And similarly we can provide Toastr warning as well. So I will open bracket, message will be warning Toastr, and for heading we will use the same as we used above. So I will type Toastr here. So now I will save it, and let's open the Chrome and refresh our page. So our page has been refreshed. So I will click on button one by one. So first of all, we have Toastr success, then we have Toastr info, then we have Toastr danger. Oh, it is not displaying Toastr danger. Let's we will check what is the problem there, and it is the Toastr warning as well. So this is the Toastr we have used, and we can also provide different options to it, like we can provide here the options, and just like we have an option tab to dismiss, and we can also provide this true. So what it will do when I will tap on the Toastr, it will dismiss. So let's go back to the Chrome, and I will refresh it by pressing F5, and when I will click on Toastr success, you can see the Toastr here. When I will click on it, it will dismiss. So similarly, we can use some other options as well, like timeout and automatically hide Toastr and display Toastr for a particular time. And this is the Toastr, how easy it is used in ASP.NET MVC application, and you can also use it in any kind of application. It is just a jQuery, and you can get this Toastr file from our internet. So our, as you can see here, we have different Toastrs we have used, how easy it is. So I hope this video will be helpful for you guys, and if you find this video helpful, kindly like this video, subscribe my channel and share this video, and I will upload some other videos as well, and you can also check my playlist related to ASP.NET MVC application and jQuery. So thank you for watching, guys.